Hello friends, we are discussing our module 3, that is the evolution. So today my topic of discussion is too interesting and very important also. So my topic of discussion is convergent evolution versus divergent evolution. What actually convergent is, you can see in this figure, means the two species, they are converging at one point and this is the point of divergence. The species are diverging. Okay, so divergent evolution and convergent evolution, what actually it is, what is the basics for this? The divergent evolution, this is the pattern of evolution in which species that were once similar divergence or become interestingly different from each other. Divergent evolution occurs when population change as they adapt to different environmental conditions. So divergent evolution in which two different taxon having two different traits evolved from common ancestors. Means they are evolving from common ancestor. Suppose with the help of this figure you can easily able to understand. Suppose this is the X species and it is getting evolved into the Y. Okay. Here is also X. Means I have told you that the ancestors, they both are same, that is the XX, and after evolution it will get converted into Z. Okay. So these two taxon, these two different taxon having different traits. They both are having different trait. Why different trait? Because they are belonging to different taxon. This is the Y and this is the Z. Okay, this is the Y. So they having different trait, but they evolving from common ancestor, that is the X. Both ancestors are same. Okay, this is the divergent evolution. Or you can say, easily understand with the help of this figure also, X, this is converting into Y, and this X, it is converting into Z. Means they are evolving from the same ancestor, but they are having different morphology, that is why they are two different species, that is Y and Z. So evolutionary pattern where ancestor migrate to different habitat and organ become modified in adaptation to new environment. Okay, so I want to tell little bit about, that is the little bit about allopatric and sympatric. What actually allopatric and what actually sympatric. So allo means the species will different at present at different place. Suppose I have taken this color for this. This is the pool, gene pool. Here so many species of A. This is the A. This is the also A. Okay, this is the A. So many A species is present. So they are evolving to different geographical area, you can say. This is the different geographical area which is shown in green color and this is the blue color. Okay. So they are going to different place. This is the A. So green color is used. Better it will be green color. Here is also A. And what about this? Here is also A. It means they are coming from the common ancestor, but they are going to the different geographical area. Suppose this is geographical area is A and this is the B. It means they are going to different geographical area. But after some time due to the environmental pressure, they will get convert into different trait. Maybe this A will convert into Z and this A will convert into Y. So they are both are having different traits. Means this is the case of allopatric. This is the allopatric. And what about sympatric? Sympatric, again I want to discuss, that is sympatric. That is the sympatric. Sim, as the name suggests, they are found at the same geographical area. Sympatric. Okay. So, suppose this is the gene pool A. The same geographical area, so many different species will evolve. Suppose this is B, C, D, E, F, means they are present at the same geographical area, but they are having different characters or different traits. Same geographical area, but they make narrow niche. So, evolutionary pattern where one species taxon sharing the different ecological niche, thus there will be existence of competition. Specialization of their ecological niche develop, ecological niche become narrow. The niche will become narrow. Suppose this is the fundamental niche, this is the specialized. Niche will become specialized. Okay. Now come to my slides. Yes. So, in this diagram, you can easily understand this is a divergent evolution, this is the parent species, and with a period of time, they are getting converted. Means this is a divergence point. They are diverging from each other in the case of A. And what about B? Again B. B, that is the convergent evolution. In parent species, they both are same. And suppose they are having the same parents or different parents. May be related or may be unrelated in convergent evolution. Parent may be related or may be unrelated. Convergent evolution, you can say in this convergent, what is the difference, basic difference between the convergent evolution and parallel evolution? So, parallel evolution, they evolve similar trait. They are evolving similar trait. And what about convergent? They are also evolving similar trait. But the convergent evolution, they are having unrelated ancestor or unrelated parental species. But what about the parallel evolution? They are having related, may be related or may be unrelated parental species. One point is similar between the convergent and parallel, that is the they are evolving similar trait. Okay, convergent is also evolving similar trait and parallel is also evolving similar trait. But the point of difference is that the convergent evolution, they are getting converted. They are coming from the unrelated parents, and parallel evolution, they are coming from related or maybe unrelated parents. Okay. This is the table through which you can easily differentiate between the convergent and divergent evolution. So, divergent, as I told you, development of different functional structure from a common ancestor form, that is the convergent. And here homologous organs show divergent evolution. Examples will be Darwin finches, Australian marsupials, locomotion in mammals. What about convergent? It follow analogous. Homologous, that is the basic similar appearance. And analogous, they are having functional similarity. So, analogous will follow convergent and homologous will follow divergent. So, convergent evolution, there will be development of similar adaptive functional structure in unrelated group of organism, that is called convergent. So, remember one point about convergent evolution, that is the unrelated group of organisms. Example will be Australian marsupials, placental mammals and various aquatic vertebrates and wings of insects, birds and bat. Yes, this is the having the common ancestor, but they are evolving in different, having the common ancestors. Now come to the examples. Convergent evolution is when multiple lineage of life independently evolve similar structures. One classic example of convergent evolution is wings. That is the birds' wings, bats, pterosaurs and insects all evolve wings for flying, but all four groups evolve from non-wing ancestors, so each type of wing is unique. Unlike the other in the structure, though their function is the same. What about divergent evolution? It occurs when one feature is modified into very different features in evolutionary descendant, and the vertebrate limb is a classic example. The first tetrapod vertebrate had a similar limb adopted for crawling on land, like that of salamander. Descendants of this ancestor have evolved all sorts of cool limbs, arms for climbing, flippers for swimming and wings for flying, shovel shapes for digging, and all evolved from the same original format. So different vertebrates, they can have widely different limb shapes, but the bones within them are always same. Means in one line you can easily understand that the convergent evolution, they are coming from unrelated species and they belongs to analogous structure. That is the convergent and analogous. And what about divergent? They belongs to the homologous. An example you can easily understand. The same underlying structure has been modified into the terms of various shapes and functions. Yes, this is also the figure which shows the convergent evolution, the divergent evolution and the parallel evolution. This is the convergent evolution, this is the divergent evolution. As the A, it is diverging into S and T, and this is the parallel evolution and this is the This is the parallel. This is the parallel and this is the convergent. They both are evolving the similar trait S and S. But what about the difference? They are coming from the same ancestors. This is the parallel. Maybe coming from same or related or unrelated. They are coming from unrelated. Now, yes, I want to tell the significance of convergent evolution. That is the coexistence of more than one unrelated taxon under similar environmental influence. So, this is the convergent evolution significance. The species can coexist. Coexistence of more than one unrelated taxon. This is the, you have to remember this point. Under similar environmental influence. Okay. So, convergent always, they are evolving from unrelated taxon. This is the point I am focusing again and again. And there will be formation of analogous similarity. Second significance about the divergent evolution is, it reduces competition. So, divergent evolution actually it adaptive radiation, it is also example of the divergent evolution. So, specialization of the multiple possible ways, thus giving taxon of the species on the pattern of radiation. That is the adaptive radiation. That is the homologous organism different in their appearance, but due to the different environmental induced force. So, what is the significance? First, it will reduce competition. Definitely, it will reduce competition. Okay. And new species, new genes, new genus, new class, new orders can be formed. Okay. So many examples I told about divergent. That is the elephant limbs in mammals. Elephant limbs, bat limbs, tiger wings, limbs, whale limbs, seal limbs, squirrel limbs. Okay. So, these all are terrestrial insectivores, and the thorns and tendrils. So, thorns of bougainvillea and tendrils of passiflora. So, they both have different functions. I told you this is the divergent evolution and this is the homologous evolution. So, thorns of Duranta and Acacia nilotica and Darwin finches, adaptive radiation in marsupials, tooth radiation also. So many examples I told you, and significance also, and convergent examples I told you, that is the flipper and fins, wings of insect birds, eyes of octopus and vertebrates, evolution of marsupials in placental animals, spines in Opuntia and Barbaris. Okay, I hope you all have understood this topic very well. This is too easy topic. If you feel any problem, you can write me in my comment box as your query. I will definitely reply as soon as possible. So friends, please try to like this video, hit the like button, share this video, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends, colleagues, batchmates. So now it is the time to say thank you friends. Once again, thank you.